गैप भी डिस्कस्ड, गैप में हमने डिस्कस कर लिया था ना क्या हुआ करके, थ्री इवोल्यूशनरी चेंजेस. सो वी रीच ऑस्ट्रेलोपिथेकस एंड वी कंक्लूडेड दैट ऑस्ट्रेलोपिथेकस इज द फर्स्ट नोन बाइपेडल एंड द फर्स्ट नोन टू हैव कल्चर. सो वी रीच ऑस्ट्रेलोपिथेकस मीनिंग सदरन एप. हु डिस्कवर्ड? रेमंड डार्ट. कहाँ पे? हाँ, टोंग, अबाउट 8 किलोमीटर फ्रॉम द मोस्ट फेमस डायमंड माइंस किम्बरले. वट वॉज द फॉसिल? 5 to 6 year old, दैट इज वट डार्ट सेट. अब यहाँ एस्टेरिक मार के यू एड एन इंफॉर्मेशन. हाउएवर डीन फॉक and others conclude that it was a 2 to 3 year old infant. At all means and others. And what is the name of this journal? Proceedings of Natural Academy of Sciences, PNAS, is written in brief that way only. It was a 2 to 3 year old infant. Fine? Time span? अब ये तो गलत बात है, अब तक तो याद हो जाना चाहिए. चलो अप टू 1.8. फिजिकल फीचर्स, क्रैनियल कैपेसिटी, एवरेज 450 cc इज एवरेज, मैक्सिमम इज 775 cc. एक्चुअली if you compare it in the case of apes, the maximum is about 650 cc. In Australopithecus the maximum is 775. In man, in genus Homo, minimum is 823 cc. What does this mean? That maximum of Australopithecus is much more than the maximum of apes, but very close to the minimum of humans. The fact is that this classification that we have done, it is on the basis of zoological criteria, most important being cranial capacity. ज्यादा cranial capacity है, higher level कर दो, कम है तो नीचे कर दो. The fact is that cranial capacity is not a good indicator of intelligence or even evolution, you can say. If that were the case, then whale and elephant should be more intelligent. But you can argue they have bigger body also. Brain to body weight ratio will be much less. And if we talk about brain to body weight ratio, our brain is something about 1.5 kg. Average weight is about 70 kg, 2%. But there are some prosimiae where weight is 50 gram, brain size, brain is 5 grams, 10%. So prosimia should be more intelligent. So cranial capacity is not a definite indicator of intelligence. So in anthropology today, the major issue is what should be called human, what should be the characteristics. The argument is we must have some absolute characteristics. And those who have argued, they have also identified two things. Anybody who is bipedal and has culture should be called human. Australopithecus had both. And those who argue this way, they even have suggested a name that he should be called Homo Africanus, the man of Africa. because all the authentic fossils of Australopithecus till date have been discovered only in Africa. Fine. Now, if you read, keep reading newspapers, yesterday only I told you that that hominins, humans of February, that is there, molecular biologists, they consider chimp and gorilla also as hominin. I told you it is wrong because their family is Mongidae. How can they belong to our subfamily? And if you include them in hominini, then the claim of Australopithecus is much stronger compared to them. At least somewhat rudimentary culture he had. So he has never asked about the debate, but you should keep in mind. And then all the features which are associated with the brain, with the skull, with locomotion. Any doubt about? Any confusion in terminology or understanding of features? The tendency should be that all physical features should be given point wise, as far as possible. So, besides all these features which are there, two evolutionary features before the class you asked, two new evolutionary features with respect to erect posture evolved in Australopithecus. Two new evolutionary features with respect to erect posture evolved in Australopithecus. Erect posture. First is mastoid. Mastoid. The inverted pyramid shaped structure. The inverted pyramid shaped structure just behind the ear. In fossil, it will be ear hole. In living, just behind the ear. Inverted pyramid shaped structure just behind the ear emerged in Australopithecus, fully developed in Homo erectus. Emerged in Australopithecus, fully developed in Homo erectus. And second is linea aspera. Linea aspera. The elongated X-shaped projection, the elongated X-shaped projection at the back of femur, the elongated X-shaped projection at the back of femur appeared in Australopithecus, fully developed in Homo erectus. This size, the thickness, it should not be more than this. Aadmi ki lagni chahiye, gai ki nahi lagni chahiye. Femur you have already seen. This is there at the back of this. You have this X-shaped, elongated X-shaped projection that is there. Fine? Of these, So both of them, both of them are direct evidences of bipedalism. Therefore, Australopithecus was bipedal. But according to the biomechanical research of Lovejoy, जिसको नाम अच्छा लगे रख ले, at least in the earlier stages, Australopithecus had shifting gait. While walking slowly. Gait means posture, you can say. When a child begins to walk, he starts running first, and when he tries to walk slow, he falls down, tumbles down. So that way, somewhat like that. There is a video also in Science Discovery. I don't know whether it's still available or not, but it is there, it shows. Any doubt? So, like last year he asked you culture of Homo erectus, this year may ask you physical features or biological features of Australopithecus. Or he may ask you physical features and phylogenetic position. Phylogenetic position means position in the evolutionary hierarchy. You know that tree, he falls between the two, between more advanced than Dryopithecus and less than Erectus. So the phylogenetic position features of Erectus which are given, initially it is comparison with Australopithecus. And evolutionary features of skull you already know. You can easily compare.